When we were starting programming, it is only my generation who can write a program for finding the square root of x, for finding the sine of x. Today's people see this as a built-in function. So these were called subroutines, now they are called APIs and so on and so forth. And the whole idea is that you have less and less to do inside, but understand. So I think the main thing is, and my problem is that creating this conversational flows is the big thing. So just like in traditional programming, it was writing the flow chart which was very important. And if you wrote the flow chart properly, like he's talking about, this is all if-then-else structure, bypassing, et cetera. And conversational flows have a bigger problem because of the non-specificity of how humans talk. And I think before you go for lunch, I would share this story with you. So IndiGo Airlines was very excited about being latest in technology, and so they decided to have a chatbot. And what happened was, one of the passengers, he flew, say, let's say from Bhubaneswar and went to Pune, but his baggage went to Bombay. As often happens, he tried also, he got no help. So in irritation, he wrote on the chatbot, "Thanks, IndiGo Airlines, for a great experience. I flew from Bhubaneswar to Pune, but my baggage went to Bombay." Now, because the chatbot had not been properly trained to understand different meanings of thank you, and that this thank you is satire and irony, he said, "We are delighted to hear that. We will assure you every time you..." And so on. So these are some of the challenges that happens.
सर इसमें मेरे साथ क्या हुआ, मेरे को कोई ऐसे रिस्पॉन्ड दे रहा था तो मैंने कहा, आर यू ए चैटबॉट? बोला नहीं, मैं ह्यूमन
So this is also very interesting. There is a whole TED talk about, can computers write poetry? So in that TED talk, what the person does, he shows you pieces of poetry, and then he asks you about, can you say, is this written by human or computer? And then obviously people make mistakes, so he says, some humans write like computers, some computers write like humans. So humans can also behave like a program chatbot. So I think it's all right, we'll have a lunch break. Come back as soon as you can. It is for you to decide how fast you want to come back. And then you can have some wrapping up time. And then we'll request Shashidhar to talk about. Because see, what is very interesting is that as you get deeper into the game, you will realize that it's not the technology which is the important part. It is the other aspect of imagining. So you actually, if you ask me, what do you have to be a good chatbot creator? You have to be a script writer. You have to imagine the possible conversations. So suddenly, when you were talking earlier about this is only for technical people, this area is completely for script writers. Because you have to imagine what the, so you imagine that this is a thing, what conversations could possibly be happening, and what would you want those conversations to be. And therefore, chatbots are supposed to have a personality of their own. Just like humans have a personality of their own, the chatbots also get a personality. Some Udyog Bhavan like fellow will simply say, "I don't understand, go back, come back again, file this," etc. But if it's a helpful person, he will try to resolve problems and so on. But this is, I think, a very good start. I mean, I can see from the enthusiasm that this idea that you will have more and more. And as he said, you create a chatbot in your image. This chatbot represents me on this topic, etc., and it eases your burden. And I think once you do this practice, so thank you for a very interesting session. This is still partial listening. We are having a lunch break and come back. And I'm happy to see all of you are very excited about it, right? So we can expect in a few months that, for example, one of the Anupam must have already thought of it, is about marketing your school.
Yes.
First thing is, he's talking about branding and marketing. The first branding marketing is to have a chatbot for your school, but not the Indigo variety. Chatbot which responds.
So we had planned to make assignments and questions based on using the
Yeah.
chatbot.
So this is again where Dr. Tyagi said very interesting thing. The conversation, most of things that you hear typically are questions asked by somebody and the chatbot responding. But in the teaching context, the chatbot may start by asking questions. You remember we learned Pythagoras theorem, now can you do this? So the chatbot may initiate the conversation rather than you ask a question. And this is the big thing. My big hope from chatbots is it simulates the conversation between a teacher and a learner. And therefore will be it's not just information seeking simplified for automation purposes. So as you get into this, you will realize more and more of how this happens. So let's have some lunch and then come back. Thank you, sir.